Okay, I'm going to do a little video here and show how to use the handles and close up the Russian backpack or Russian potato sack here, basically. Alright. So it's basically just a big potato sack, as I said. You got your... There's a draw string on the top here. I got a blanket in here just so it gives it some... so it's not flat. So you just cinch up the top here to start with. Put it on the camera here. So you just cinch this up. It's a tiny bit stubborn. Get her up, cinched up pretty good like that, I guess. So it's not for government work. Communist work, I guess. So you take your drawstring, which is pretty dodgy looking hemp, but it works, I guess. So it's like Dollarama hemp. But just wrap. You can wrap it around here if you want to tie this off more. Just wrap it around. You don't want to, you don't have to, but. Like that. Alright. So now you want to attach your back straps to it. So, easiest way I noticed was they go from, there's five rows of stitching, then they merge to three on this one anyway. You can see that. Just pinch together, get it kind of squared up a little bit. Just sort of, squared up where they merge from five to three. And basically just fold it over like this. Like that. And so you can put your hand through like that if you want. Like that. And then you can just take it and grab the top, pull that through. Then you just cinch it down like so. And then you can kind of adjust the strap however you want to, because they don't usually work out perfect. You got these straps down here to go across your chest. They go sort of just above breast level. Those they'd be up here somewhere. You buckle those. Let's see, more or less go through the far one. The close one, and then you put it through the little retainer thing here, and then you can pull it tight. That's more or less to pull it together and then hold the straps on your shoulders so they don't slip off. I saw one video, the guy complained about it. He's saying they didn't fit on most people from like in the Western world, but if it goes up high enough, hopefully you're not that big up that high. And he must have thought they went down, you know, down here somewhere, which isn't really practical. It's they're meant to go higher up, and then you can turn the straps inside of them just to get them sort of square. And there's adjustments down here as well, but, so that goes there just to keep these from, you know, the straps from coming apart and coming off your shoulders. But it's a really good. The way this works is really good in my opinion, because the more weight is on it, it would tighten, so it's not going to pull off. If these are just sewn into the canvas body of the bag, you know, this canvas is decent, but they'd pull out if it was really heavy kind of stuff you had in this. And you can adjust this. You can, you know, if it's not that much stuff, you can adjust the handle down here. You can put it up there. Whatever, there's a reason the Russians use this for like 100 years, so, in my opinion. But, just put kind of stuff out, whatever you want to, in the main bag. There is the front bag, for, you know, for stuff that you want to get at easily, without opening it. I use this for hunting or something. I put, like, you know, like deer license or something in the front here. You may look medical kit or whatever, fire start and stuff, or you know, whatever kind of extra ammo or something. I'm going to put that in the front there. You get these side straps. I was thinking I might put my little Hultifers mini axe on the side here or something. I'd probably be able to figure that out, put that on there. Instead of putting a blanket, I don't know. Like, I was thinking, like, if you had a bedroll, it'd probably be better to put it, like, inside the backpack itself and using it to sort of pad stuff you had in there that was kind of pokey, because since it doesn't have any, like, frame or anything, you put a bunch of stuff in here, it might be kind of jabby against your back, so you just maybe put your wool blanket inside here, and that would protect you against that kind of stuff. But it's, you know, for the price, like, $20, like, this thing is really good. It's good for a lot of stuff. It's a decent size. I'm really tempted to buy another one, because it, you know, you can make up a bag for hunting, make up one for, you know, day bag for hiking, or, you know, you can make up different ones and have them all set up so you don't have to worry about, you know, taking stuff out of this and put it in that and messing around with it and everything. So, but, really, for the price, it's an awesome thing, and they're all, most of the ones you buy on eBay are, you know, new old stock, so it's basically brand new. It's just been sitting in a warehouse for 30 years. I think this one's made in 1988, this one. I looked at the date right. So, anyway, thanks for watching, guys, and we'll talk to you later.